愿主与你们同在，
与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣马古福音。天主子耶稣基督福音的开始，正如以赛亚书上记录的，看哪，我要派遣我的使者做你的前驱，为你开路。旷野中有人大声呼喊说，你们当预备上主的道，修治他的路。使者若翰便在旷野里出现，为人施洗，宣讲悔改的洗礼，为世人得到罪的赦免。有许多人从犹太各地和耶路撒冷来到若翰那里，承认自己的罪过，在约旦河里接受他的洗礼。若翰身穿骆驼毛做的衣服，腰间束着皮带，吃的是蝗虫与野蜂蜜。他宣布说，在我以后要来的哪一位比我能力强，我连弯腰给他解鞋带子也不配。我用水洗你们，他却要用圣神洗你们。基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
如果我们常常开车或者坐在车上，你跑全马都好了，全马来西亚，你会知道我们路是很狭窄的。我们很多时候我们跑路 ，highway 也好，小路也好，很多洞啊，不平啊，就是很多我们的路程。很多时候是不顺的，而我们又常常投诉说，为什么人没有去修补那些洞啊，修这条路啊，让我们能够走好一点。因为如果一条路不好走的话，我们的车也是就会很快就坏了的。如果太多洞的话，也是不能跑，就咚咚咚这样子，你 suspension 也是坏的。你的路不平，很多东西折度，我们也是要慢跑，也是 brake 皮也是完蛋的，油也是吃很快。那为什么我讲到路跟车跟我们的心的关系？因为我们每个人知道开车有时候很辛苦啦，路不好，我们的心情也不好了的。很多洞我们也不能跑太快，心情也不好，所以。如果一条路做到很好，做到很新，这样平没有动，什么都没有，我们当然我们路程会很比较顺，然后我们心情也是更好。耶稣天主的道路也是这样子的，我们其实没有想到，我们每个人其实没有真正讲到这条路的意思。我们知道我们是朝圣者，走着这条路，但是有没有想到？路是好还是坏，还是已经有很多洞了，还是已经不平了，我们还是只是走。所以有时候我们为什么犯罪啊，为什么有时候我们讲为什么每次这样子 做到不好，祈祷不好，所以有时候我们遇到很多洞就跌下去了，有很多洞跑太快，碰到那个洞打压也爆了，我们就跌着爆了。所以如果我们没有修改自己的这个道路，我们也很难走的，我们的心情永远是不安静的。但我们怎么样去修这条路呢？路每一个人都要走的，我们全部走同样一条路。所以你看，如果一条路的话，很多 很多车一直用着，一直走，罗里车、摩托、脚车全部，迟早那条路也是会慢慢的裂，会坏的。我们的道路像天主那个道路也是一样，我们每一个人走同样的一条路，但是我们可能没有发现到，是因为我们常常犯罪，常常可能不小心得罪天主，还是得罪别人，就不小心做不太好的事情，我们能就让那条路变坏得很快。所以我们每个人有那个责任去修这那条路，不能说这不是我的责任，这条路不好政府要做，那当然外面的路是政府做了，这不是我们做了，我们有没有去补的。但是我们灵修的道路，每一个人有这个责任去修治，不能说不是我的责任，我要我自己祈祷就好了，我不管别人，让别人去处理，也不能这样子说的。因为那我们也是用同样的一条路，如果我们一直用不帮着别人救治，也是一个很自私的行为。当然我们怎么样去修治呢？就是祈祷，一是要祈祷，一就是祈祷，二就是专心向着天主，第三就是真的要了解我们教会的教导。很多时候我们怎么都不知道，因为可能是无知，或者说哎呀这些东西不重要啦，最重要是要祈祷过了，做一个好人。但是如果我们不知道天主教我们教的 这些教导，我们怎么样去知道我们做的是好还是坏，我们也不知道的。所以我们不能说这些不重要，是很重要的。用这些方式，然后就用那些某一个圣人的灵修，他们的写作，其实你能够帮到我们每天的，不只是灵修生活，常常我们每一天的挑战和诱惑。这就是真正修治的天主的道路。不然的话，我们如果每天这样子只是走，一直走，一直走，没有发现到那条路有时候是坏了，不是说坏，只是不太好，对我们的行程会比较慢，对我们的心情有时候不太好。如果我们真的能够把每一个人能够把那这条路修治好的话，我们的行程会比较顺一点，然后我们心情也比较好。这是因为我们就会想到别人，为别人祈祷，用我们所学到的去帮助别人，这就是真正修治天主道路的意思。所以这个降临期不只是降临期而已，降临期当然是叫我们真的悔改，悔改心从天主，悔改因为要迎接天主子将来。所以如果我们真的要快要到我们的目的，这条路如果能够修治好的话，就是平没有动，我们的这个降临期的行程会比较有意义。Now, just maybe a short one. Now, when all of us have driven cars or we are sitting in cars before, in Malaysia or wherever you are, you know our roads are not very good. It's sometimes there are a lot of potholes, it's not very flat, a lot of obstacles, and sometimes trees fall here and there, no light. And often we complain why nobody does anything, you know, and sometimes we go too fast, we sometimes spoil our car, because if you hit a hole, you either blow a tire or your suspension goes. Sooner or later, your whole car will break down. Same with the non-flat road that has many, many obstacles. That will actually wear out our brakes and you cause us a lot of petrol. But the thing is this, of course, we can't do anything about the physical road. But if you use that as an analogy for our own spiritual life, we are also traveling on some kind of road. Now today, John, the gospel tells us to make straight the path to God, the path of heaven. How do we make that straight? I mean, we can't see the path. Actually, we are. But it's not a physical path. It's a spiritual path that all of us are walking on or traveling on. So if we do not repair the road, because a road that is used often by different vehicles, different loads, will cause the road to fail. So when we are on this spiritual road, all of us travel on it with different backgrounds, with different hurts, with different sins, with different challenges and temptation. So all this would actually hurt the road also. And in order to repair that road, we need to really follow what John the Baptist say, to repent, to see that what we do actually causes a lot of harm to this path to God. And that will actually cause other people to fall as well. And we cannot say that it is me, I don't care about others, this is my journey. No, we are a pilgrim together on this journey of life, on this highway, and it's our everyone's responsibility to go keep it, maintain it, to make sure that whoever uses that road will find it easier to get to God. The more potholes, the more difficult the road is, the more frustrated we become. We know this to be true because on a physical road, every time we get a very bad road, we just grumble and grumble and grumble. But it is the same for the spiritual road. If that road is not nice to travel on, then we will not be at peace. We will always fall. And all these potholes and whatnot is the cause of our own downfall. And so it is not perfect, but we are continually asked to repair, to maintain this road so that everyone will be able to use this highway to God. How to repair it? Through our own prayers for ourselves, through our prayer for others, to pray for others, to also understand what the teaching of the church and what the teaching of the gospel is. Because we cannot claim ignorance or to say that those are not important. How do we know what we are doing is right or wrong? How do you know that the direction we are taking is correct if we do not know any of this? So we have to understand that in order to keep this road well maintained, all this needs to be within us. The disposition of wanting to know the teachings of the church, the writings of the saints that can help us navigate the potholes and the obstacles along our road. And so it's not just this Advent, but every day of our life to help ourselves and to help one another so that when this road is always maintained, then our spiritual journey will be smoother and all of us will be able to make it there together.